Motivation, soft skills, and training session. So yesterday we learned about the body language skills and how to speak public speaking skills and how to overcome the fear of public speaking. So to know more, we are here today. So over to you, Richa, Ms. Richa.
Thank you, Spandana. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Subrat. Good morning, Umang. How are you all doing? Subrat, you can hear me? Okay, good morning, Umang. I feel you still are facing some technical difficulties, so you can continue to use the chat box. And Subrat, I hope you're able to see me, hear me properly. I hope I'm audible.
Yes.
All right, good. I'm good, Umang. Thank you so much. And hope you're also doing well. Welcome to day 4 of our session on soft skills and personality development. I did receive your assignments for yesterday, and I will be going through them today for the fear of public speaking that you all have shared with me, as well as the other assignment. All right. So are we excited for our session today? Please give me a thumbs up. Yes, a nice, energetic good morning. Hi, Mayuri. How are you?
Hello, ma'am. Good morning. I'm fine.
Good morning.
And what about you?
I'm also doing well. Thank you for asking. All right, great. So are we excited for our session today?
Yes.
Superb. I'm also excited to be here as a part of this session with all of you. Today, we're going to cover, so before we start with our session today, let's do a quick recap for 5 minutes on what we had learned yesterday. What were your key learnings and key takeaways from our session yesterday, right? So Mayuri, let me start with you. What did you learn yesterday in the session? What were your key takeaways? Umang, you can mention yours in the chat box, please. Mayuri? Okay, let's move on to you, Subrat. By the time Mayuri probably... Okay, she's unmuted now. Yes, Mayuri. Key learnings from yesterday's session? Okay, Subrat, why don't you start and then Mayuri can follow afterwards.
Okay, so basically we learned how to be a good speaker from an audience perspective as well as from a speaker's perspective.
Okay.
As a speaker, the confidence is a very important thing.
Mm-hmm.
Then the opening, the mm-hmm. body of the speech and the closing, these three mm-hmm. things.
Okay.
Then be prepared and be well practiced with your speeches.
Mm-hmm.
And do not fall for negative thoughts.
Okay.
And from an audience perspective, the speaker the speech should be engaging
mm-hmm.
and well written.
Okay.
And I guess that's all.
Okay. We also covered a little bit on body language yesterday.
Yes. Yes.
So what did we learn about body language?
The body language should be expressive.
Mm-hmm.
The speaker should not have a very informal body language whenever you are on stage.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And the gestures and postures should be energetic, not lethargic.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
And that's all, I guess.
Yes, good, good. Thank you for sharing that, Subrat. So yes, what we had learned yesterday was one step which is going to make you a little more confident with your personality development and soft skills. And that was one, body language, how you communicate with your body language to people. And 80% of our communication happens through body language is what we had studied. How we have to use our postures, gestures in the right manner, the facial expressions, so as to build a nice impression with the opposite person, be it for an interview or be it for or any meeting that you're going to, or just, you know, basic etiquette at the workplace also. So body language plays a crucial role in that, and how we have to be mindful of our body language. Just as Suvrat was saying, we need to make sure that our body language comes across as energetic and enthusiastic, rather than having a dull and boring kind of a body language. You know, when you're sitting, your shoulders should be back, your back should be straight, you should lean a little forward. Also, when you are, you know, speaking to somebody, make sure that your hands are, palms are open, not having closed palms, not having crossed arms. You know, when you're sitting down, make sure that feet is, you know, not, your legs are not cross leg. You're not tapping your feet, or you're not tapping or drumming your fingers on the table. These are all signs of anxiety and nervousness. Do not bite your nails. Do not fidget with your face or your clothing, etc. These are all signs of nervousness or signs of anxiety. Having said that, we move on. Yesterday, then again in the session, we moved on to how you have to be more effective as a speaker. Certain things that you can do to ensure that you're not fearful of public speaking is, you need to take deep breaths. You need to ensure that you visualize success. You visualize that you have given a good presentation or a speech and not be scared about it. These are small things which will help you to really enhance your public speaking skills. As an audience, you need to, you know, when you're sitting as an audience, you need somebody who's interactive with you, not a one-way speech, but a two-way communication, right? That makes a speech or a presentation more enjoyable and more, focused on what you really want to achieve. Also, one more thing that I feel some of you have left out from yesterday's session, we spoke about the opening, the body, and the closing of a speech or a presentation, right? So the opening has to be really killer opening, in the sense that you don't have to kill people with your opening. I'm not mentioning that, but it has to hook the audience. Yeah. The first 10 or 15 seconds, the audience listens to you and will decide whether they want to listen to you or they don't want to listen to you. They will be present, definitely, but they will be only physically present. Mentally, they will be somewhere else. Now, as a speaker, that's the worst nightmare. Okay. When your audience is physically there, but mentally somewhere else. Okay. So, how you make that killer opening, how you make that hook opening, is by starting your speech or presentation with a question, with a sharing of any fact, with a nice, interesting quotation. Yeah, so these are small things that you can start your opening with. Okay, again, moving on to the body, you need to make sure that the body of the presentation is very, very crisp, to the point, detail mein hona chahiye, but not too much in detail. And then the closing also has to be a very, a very fine closing, not just an abrupt closing that you just suddenly say, thank you very much, everyone, and that's the end of my presentation. No, you have to do a small recap of what you have spoken about in your presentation, a small summary, have a small Q&A for the audience. And that's how you would close it, probably with a statement, with a key takeaway for the people, or with a fact sharing, or with a nice quotation to end the presentation. But the closing has to be memorable. It should be something that the audience takes away with them and remembers your presentation or speech for a long, long, long time. All right. So that is what we had covered yesterday. Now let's move on to our session today. And today what we will cover is on verbal communication. All right. So let me start by sharing the screen with y'all. I hope y'all can see my screen. Please give me a thumbs up in the chat box if you can.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Great. Thank you. All right. So, today we are going to be concentrating on verbal communication, is the way you speak, right? What is the objective of our session? What is the agenda? We'll talk about the importance of communication. We'll talk about the components of verbal communication and what really is a verbal communication made up of. We'll also talk about how to be more and more confident while you're communicating. We'll talk about proper articulation. We'll talk about presenting ideas and thoughts effectively. And last but not the least, we'll talk about the 7 C's of communication. All right. I would encourage you all to have your notepads and pens ready to jot down anything you feel you want to write down and that you can refer to at a later stage. All right. So let's begin. All right. So this, we're going to start by having a small activity. This activity is called as My Passion. Okay. Now, what I would want all of you all to do is think of anything that you're passionate about. It could be cricket, it could be music, it could be dancing, it could be anything at all, whatever you're passionate about. And I want you to prepare a small 1 minute or a 2 minute speech for that. Okay. And I'm going to give you 5 minutes to get your ideas in order. Okay, and after 5 minutes, I'm going to ask each one of you to present here in front of everybody. All right. Now, when I give you this particular work to do or this activity to do, I want you to keep in mind whatever we've learned in our session yesterday about presentation and speech. Okay. So make sure that you include all of those things, even the body language part of it, even the opening, closing body of the presentation. So it's a small speech that you have to prepare, but it has to have all the ingredients, whatever we've spoken about yesterday. Okay. So any questions on this activity? Are we clear?
Yes.
Okay. Mayuri and Suvrat, I would want you all to keep your cameras on when you present this particular My Passion speech. Umang, I know you're having technical difficulties, but if you can try and have your video on. If not, then we'll let that happen go. Probably you can just record and send it to me later. Okay. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes and your time starts now. Please start preparing.
Ma'am, some network issue, camera on.
Okay, no worries. So you can just speak. Let's have your audio without the video.
Yes, ma'am. Photography is my passion. Photography is my window of the world to see, express myself. I enjoy a lot as then I come from small city and this experience was an eye-opener for me. I created my own photography project about art of tattoo and I had to do in my own. It gave the strength to believe that I can do everything and is possible. The world seems completely different and I seem to be a completely different person and I am myself. Thank you.
Okay. All right. Thank you for sharing that. Small feedback, Mayuri. I hope that's okay for me to give it to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, before I give my feedback, I would want, Suvrat, what is your take on her presentation and her small speech?
Ma'am, her points were very good, but the structure could have been better, the starting and ending, and some more expressiveness would have been there.
Yes.
Could have been there.
Okay. All right. Thanks for sharing that. Umang, you can have your feedback about Mayuri in the chat box, please. So Mayuri, it was nice, small, crisp speech that you just gave. However, a couple of things which I feel can be your areas of improvement, which I would want you all to jot down, please. Okay. This is the area that, these are the couple of things that I would want you to start working on, okay, for your own improvement of speech. Okay. The first thing is the opening. As I mentioned, the opening has to be impactful, right? It has to be something which makes people sit up and pay attention to what you want to say, right? So as I mentioned, the opening line has to be a hook line, okay, which I thought was missing. What was your opening like? You just mentioned something like photography. I like photography or something, right?
Yes.
So that has to change. It's very generic. Today, if you want to stand out from the crowd, you have to do something different, right? You can't do same what other people are doing. You can't have the herd mentality, right? So the opening could have been a little bit more about, so photography is what you like, right? So it could have been a nice opening statement with a quotation about photography, or it could be a question about photography to other people, you know? So these are the kind of opening lines I was suggesting when I was taking the session yesterday. The opening has to be like very, very impactful. The closing again was, I felt, was missing that edge. Okay. So closing again could have been a little bit more impactful. The structure was a little, it was not fine-tuned. Okay. While you were going on, we were not, I mean, at least I was not able to understand what exactly was the structure. So it had to be a little bit more fine-tuned. Okay. The next thing which I feel was that your speech was a little rushed up. Okay, I feel you need to slow down. Okay, like I had mentioned, I think the other day also, I felt like you're a Rajdhani Express. You were just going on and on. Yeah. And I completely understand that because once I was also where you are, okay, I have a very fast rate of speech. I can speak like really fast. And at times I have to tell myself, Richa, slow down, don't go so fast. So you have to probably use some tactic or some kind of, you know, like a, you know, self thing saying that, okay, you have to slow down a little bit. So I feel you, your rate of speech is a little fast and you need to slow up. Also, another thing which I feel, Mayuri, you need to improve on is your tone. Okay. The tone has to be, there has to be intonation. What do I mean by intonation? So we're going to cover that today, but just to give you a small piece of suggestion over here. Tone has to be not monotonous. It has to be vary, you know, it has to vary. So it, that makes it interesting for the audience to listen to. Otherwise, if you speak in the same tone, flat tone, people will not be interested to listen, right? So you need to consciously make an effort to have a variation in your tone. Make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
So these were the areas I feel you can improve on, and I hope you have written it down and you will start working on these. All right?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Let's have Subrat. Let's have you next.
Am I visible and audible?
Yes, you are. Thank you. Mayuri, I would also want you to jot down feedback for Subrat, okay? Like he has for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I'm going to read because I was not able to memorize all this stuff in 5 minutes. Okay, so shall I start?
Yes, please.
Okay, so being passionate, following your dreams, chasing your talent, all these things sound pretty good, right? But you know what? Here's a fun fact. That 50% of the people who follow their passion end up being financially broke. I don't mean to discourage you all, but there's a proper way to it. Okay, a very warm welcome to each and every listen. My name is Subrat Mishra, and even I have a passion. Since I was 5 years old, I've been learning music. I learned tabla, guitar, and keyboard, and I worked for different bands in my city. Being on radio a couple of times gave me a sense of confidence and a sense of responsibility towards what I was doing. It has made me a different person as well. Music is a stress buster for me. And as I mentioned earlier, there's a proper way to do it. You can plan your career along with your passion with a sense of responsibility. After all, the world is a global village and is never short of opportunities these days. You just have to be the right person at the right place. Thank you for listening. Thank you for giving me your time. Thanks a lot.
All right, great. Thank you so much, Subrat. And Mayuri, what is your feedback on Subrat's presentation or speech?
Always does proper speech.
Sorry, come again. Okay, we are not able to hear you.
He's an excellent way to organizing ideas and views a logical manner. Then,
all right, great. Thank you for sharing that. So Subrat, nicely put. Okay, the speech was very crisp. You knew what you were talking about. Your rate of speech is also all right. It was neither too fast, neither too slow. However, when you were covering some important point that time, it would have been great if you would have paused a little bit or went a little slow on that thing. Okay. Like for example, one line that you mentioned, when you follow your passion, your income suffers or some financial thing you mentioned, right? So that was a very important line. And if you just say it in a, you know, like with the, along with the speech, like how you're saying the rest of the things, it'll miss the point. So that was a line which I would have preferred. You would have gone a little slow and said each word at you know, with emphasis. You understand that?
Yes, so, I'm getting.
Yes, so you know, whatever is your you know, main key things in your speech, that has to be spoken with a little less rate of speech. Okay, you have to slow down to make that impact on people. Okay, otherwise it'll just go as a passing Got it. I loved the opening. The opening was really good, Suvrat. The way you you did not start, "Hi, my name is Suvrat Mishra and I'm here to talk about blah, blah, blah." You did not do that, which is a very good thing. You started your opening with a nice quotation and a nice, catchy thing. So that was nice. Even the closing was good, wherein you thanked everyone for their time and stuff like that. Body language, Suvrat, is probably starting where you had some, your hands on your cheek and stuff like that, which then I think you realized that, your body language was a little negative. And then I think you self-corrected yourself. But having said that, I think it was really well put together and there's nothing to complain. You're doing very well. Yeah. So good job.
Thank you, ma'am.
Fantastic. Umang, we are looking forward to hearing from you. Would you be able to put on your, unmute yourself and speak to us? Is Umang there or has she left the meeting? I can't see her. Manveer, Spandana, anybody can check with her?
Sure, we'll check on it.
Sure, because I think she's logged out from the meeting or she's not here. Okay, I think she's just come back. Umang, would you like to share your talk with us? If you can unmute and speak, please. Okay. I think we'll let her, as and when she's ready, she can do that. Moving forward from here, so how was this activity, friends? Did you all enjoy doing this?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Great. So these are all learnings, okay? And this I would really want you all to do very, very often, to practice, to improve your speaking skills and to get the fear out and to include whatever we've learned. It's a good way to practice it by continuously doing these small activities yourself. Okay, moving on from here, let me start sharing my screen with you once again. Okay. So what we're going to cover now, we start with having understanding about what exactly is communication. So as we all know, you all would have studied in your school days, college days, communication is nothing but the use of language to communicate through a medium, how you express yourself, how you get your ideas across to the others, and how you really connect with the person whom you're speaking with. This is all what communication is, right? Now, communication has to be a two-way process, okay? And there are six steps in communication. Firstly, you formulate the idea in your head. Like right now, when I gave you this particular activity to do, you started thinking about your ideas. Then you encode it, the language that is there. Then you start speaking. That is a transmission of the communication by through emails or through speech or through telephones, whatever it may be, the medium to transmit. Then there's a person who receives your communication. Right now, you all were the communicators, you all were the senders, I was the receiver. Okay, so we receive the message, in which you have to actively listen and you have to have focus approach. Then the person who's the receiver decodes that entire message which the encoder has and understands what is the desired outcome. And lastly, understanding from a receiver's point of view, you ask questions and share your understanding, right? So right now, you all were the senders, I was the receiver, I understood what you all were trying to say, and I was giving you all feedback, saying that, yes, I have understood, and this is your area of improvement. Now, if a person thinks of A, the sender is thinking of A, but the receiver is thinking that thing as X or Y, then there is definitely a misunderstanding and definitely a lack of communication skills. Okay. So, which brings me to my next topic, as what are certain barriers in communication? Okay. So I'm going to put you into your respective breakout rooms right now. I want you all to take about 5 minutes and think about what you feel are some of the barriers in communication. Okay, like for example, one, language can be a barrier in communication. Okay, when you don't speak the language of the audience, that can be a definite barrier. In the same way, I want you all to think about as many barriers as you can, which are barriers in communication. Okay, any questions on this?
No, ma'am.
All right. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes. I'm assigning you to your breakout rooms and I'll see you after 5 minutes. and we will discuss.
They can't express themselves.
How we can write this too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who and all are in this breakout room? Because from what I can see, I am in breakout room with Surat, and but you are speaking, that's why I am confused. Okay, do you have any other points?
I think that we have other barriers when we are speaking to someone. The language is the first, which is the
yes.
important. Yeah.
You can think of your more if you have any.
All right.
Okay.
All right. I believe everybody is back in the main session. I can
yes.
see everybody. All right. Good. All right. So let's quickly have a discussion on what you all were having a discussion in your breakout room on barriers of communication. Let's start with the first team, Mayuri. And Mayuri, who was with you? Was it Umang?
Umang. Yes,
okay.
Umang.
All right. So either one of you can present. Mayuri, you can start.
Yes, ma'am. The barrier is lack of attention, interest, and distraction to the person listening.
Mm-hmm.
Then different languages and unfamiliar accents, uncomfortable temperature, background noise,
mm-hmm.
poor lightning, problem or speech difficulties, physical disabilities such as hearing. Different in perception and viewpoint then.
Okay. That's all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fantastic. Good points, Mayuri. I believe Umang has also the same points, right?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Thank you for sharing. Let's move over to Suvrat and Spandana.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. So not initiating the conversation may be a point.
Mm-hmm.
The either person is not willing to initiate the conversation, then how will it happen?
Mm-hmm.
Lack of confidence, speech disorder, hearing disorder,
mm-hmm.
cultural differences,
mm-hmm.
attitude and behavioral issues,
right?
Emotional intelligence,
mm-hmm.
then using unfamiliar vocabs, there's a specific word for them. Yeah, jargons, using jargons.
Yes.
And cultural shocks, I guess.
Yes, very good.
And that's all I can think of.
Fantastic. Spandana, I believe you also have the similar points, or you have something else you would want to contribute on?
Almost similar. If you are like a use of wrong expressions or idioms, that can also affect. And also saying any things ambiguously. So people will be confused on what it actually means. And wrong use of gestures, hand gestures, and hand signals, it can offend someone. And how they interpret it, their perception of perception also difference will be there. That's all.
Sure. All right, great. Thank you so much, everyone, for sharing. Most of the points are same. However, there are few which are which I would like to share with you all over here. So certain barriers in communication or of communication are hearing only a part of the message. The speaker wants to say a lot of things, but as a receiver, you only hear a part of it. That can be a barrier. Failure to listen can be a barrier. Listening with a particular mindset or prejudice or judgment about the person can be a barrier. Reacting emotionally, making assumption, accents can be a barrier. Physical barriers, cultural barriers, religious barriers, time pressures, some interruption or distraction in the form of social media or phones and stuff like that. Failure to wait for the feedback can be a barrier. Lack of sensitivity. from a receiver side can also be a barrier. Poor volume, tone, emphasis, finishing a person's sentence for him or her, that we do a lot of times, right? The person is speaking, they have still not finished speaking, but we end up finishing up their sentence. So that is again a barrier. Not acknowledging a person's emotions, feelings, desires, experiences, all of these are barriers to communication, all right? So having said that, let's move forward. I believe I had spoken to you about Albert Mehrabian's theory, I think day before yesterday, if I'm not mistaken. So these are elements of communication. Only 7% are spoken words important. 38% important is the way you speak, your voice and your tone. And 55% is the importance of body language. So this is out of 100. And as you can see, body language tops it with 55. The next thing is your way of speaking. So the tone you use, the pronunciation, your voice, intonation, all of these things comes here. Okay. So let's do a small activity right now. This activity is called as Bollywood Hangama. Okay. It's a fun activity. And I think you all will just roll up in laughter when you do this. Okay. So what we will do is I'm going to give each person one famous Bollywood ka dialogue. Okay. Now that sentence or that dialogue, you have to say in four different emotions. Please write down what are these four different emotions. One is happy. You have to say the dialogue in a happy manner. Second is sad. Third is anger. In an angry way, you have to say that. And the fourth one is frustrated. In a frustrated manner or irritated manner, you have to say that sentence. Got it, everyone? So I'm going to share, gave all of you that dialogues. So Suvrat, your dialogue, can you please write it down or just remember it? Okay.
Yes. Is
Rahul, naam to suna hoga. Okay. This is your dialogue. You have to say it in four different emotions. Angry, happy, sad, and frustrated or irritated. Okay. Please practice. Now, in the next 2 minutes, we'll start this activity. Mayuri, your dialogue is ab tera kya hoga kalia. Okay. You have to say this in all these four different emotions, which I've just mentioned. Umang, I'm sorry, you'll not be able to do this activity because you can't unmute and we are not able to see you also. So I don't know. I don't see the purpose of giving you this activity because it'll not be, you'll not be able to do it. Okay. And Spandana, you can take this dialogue. Don ko pakadna mushkil hi nahi, namumkin hai. Okay. All right. So please start thinking about how you will say in angry way, happy way, sad way, and frustrated way. I'm going to give you just 1 minute. It has to be spontaneous.
Okay, so do I have to turn on the camera or just say?
You can turn on the camera. Don't tell us which emotion you're portraying. Let us guess which emotion that is, okay? You can put on your camera.
Okay, this might turn on to be a little embarrassing for me.
Don't worry. The idea is just to have a little fun over here. We've been studying very hard since morning, so it's time for a quick energizer. Yes.
Rahul, naam to suna hoga.
Okay, what do you all say? What emotion was this? Mayuri, Spandana, Umang. Again, once more.
Awesome expression.
Suvrat, once more.
The previous one or the next emotion?
The first one. Okay, let's do all four together and then we'll see.
Okay, I'll start. Once again. Rahul, naam to suna hoga.
Okay. Did it look happy, everyone?
Yes.
Okay, next one, Suvrat.
Rahul, naam to suna hoga.
Very sad. Next.
Rahul, naam to suna hoga.
Mayuri, which one is this?
Fantastic, ma'am.
Huh? Angry, right?
She is enjoying a lot.
Yes, I can. In her time also, we'll enjoy a lot. Don't worry. And the last one.
Rahul, naam to suna hoga na yaar.
You can definitely get into acting after this, Suvrat.
Oh, please spare me on that.
No worries. Okay, thank you very much. A big hand to Suvrat for this. So we saw different emotions there, right? Mayuri, over to you.
Yes, ma'am. अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया?
ओके
हैप्पी मोमेंट
यस
देन अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया?
वेरी सैड नेक्स्ट
अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? फ्रस्टेड
दिस वाज एंग्री
देन नो या
बट इट हैड टू शो लिटिल मोर एंगर
अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? यस यस लास्ट अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? फ्रस्टेड
Mayuri, honestly, all four are sounding the same. Yeah, Subrat?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so वो ज़्यादा उसमें variation नहीं दिखाई दिया Mayuri. सारे same pattern में आपने बोला है. अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? अब तेरा क्या होगा कालिया? So it was there was no differentiating factor. Okay. Now the reason why we are doing this. Okay, sorry, Spandana, you are left. My apologies. Please go ahead. You can put on.
I have too long of a sentence. I'll just say one thing and you can guess, I guess.
Okay.
Okay. अरे यार ढोंग को पकड़ना मुश्किल ही नहीं ना मुमकिन है यार.
अपने अपने भी words डाल दिए यार. Okay. I guess it was sad.
I was going for frustrated but sad.
Okay, it was looking, I mean, sounding like both frustrated and sad. Okay, good. Thank you, Spandana. All right, so there's a reason why we did this activity, friends. We've done this for to understand how tone plays a very important role, all right? In communication, the way you use your tone, this is one of the factors of communication, the voice, the volume, the tone, the emphasis on the right word, the stressing on that correct word. These are all which come out from this activity, right? So what are some of the factors that impact your speech? One is the tone of the voice. Some people have a very, a tone which is very harsh. Some people have a very polite tone. So you have to be mindful of what is the kind of tone you want to portray whenever you are having a speech or a presentation or when you're communicating with people. Second thing is emphasis or stressing on the words. Again, this is something which is very important. When you have something of important to say, you have to stress on that particular word or that particular phrase. Okay, then only the impact of that will come out stronger. Yeah, pronunciation. Today, this is something which is very, very critical to communication. Agar aapka pronunciation right nahi hai, sahi nahi hai, then entire communication can have a very bad backfiring on you. Okay, so you have to make sure that nowadays what happens, many of us have MTI problem. MTI is what? Mother tongue influence. We use a lot of Indianisms also. So pronunciation has to be very importantly, thought about. Like, I'll give you an example. A couple of years back, one of my friends, she's a Gujarati. Please excuse me, all the Gujaratis over here. Please don't take offense. This is just an example, hypothetical thing, which I'm not hypothetical, something which had happened with me a couple of years back. A Gujarati friend of mine said, okay, let's go and have some snakes. I said, what? You want us to go and have some snakes? Later on, one of the other friend of mine told me, she mentioned as snacks, not snakes. Okay, so pronunciation can be a very, very, something which can really make or break an impression, all right? So you have to be mindful of your pronunciation. If you're not sure, look it up in the dictionary of the right way of pronouncing that particular thing. Okay, volume has to be just right. If you're speaking in a group, a big room with many people, you have to make sure that your volume is adjusted accordingly. Pace and pauses, very important. You have to pace your presentation properly. You have to have the right kind of pauses. As I was mentioning to Mayuri, you have to pause. Okay, you cannot read your speech like you are on a spree or you are on a sprint. Okay, you have to slow down. You have to pace your presentation. You have to have the pauses at the right place to make an impact. Otherwise, kya hota hai? You're done with your speech, but it is not impactful. Okay.
Okay.
And fluency is very important. You need to be fluent in the language. If it's English ho, Hindi ho, Marathi ho, whatever it is, you have to have that fluency in that language. Only then can you make a good impact with your speech or a presentation. Okay, Umang has been getting locked off quite often. I'm admitting her again, but Manbir, you might want to check with her, post our session, that why she's getting locked out so often, because she's missing out on very important points over here. All right. Okay. Now, one of the important components of communication is listening. So listening is, communication is not always about talking. Communication is also about listening. And that is a challenge which many, many of us face nowadays. Are you a good listener? Do you, when people are speaking, do you actually make a point of leaving everything and just listening to them without any distraction, without having, so giving them your 100%? There's a very famous, quotation by Mr. Bob Conklin. He said that people don't care how much you know, but they know how much you care by the way you listen. And that's, I think, one of the greatest quality of a communicator. Don't talk much, but listen more to people. And that's genuinely, I will tell you, a challenge with today's, with people today, So that's listening. Now, there are different levels of listening. One is ignore, wherein you just don't listen, you ignore the person. Second is that you pretend to listen. And many of us, I feel, have been over here, wherein we are pretending to listen, but we are actually not listening. The next is selective listening. What is selective listening? Suvrat?
Yes, ma'am.
What is selective listening?
Listening to just the things that you want to listen, yes. Getting okay. The points.
Hmm. Listening to only what you want to hear and not listening to the rest of it. That's selective listening. Okay, jo aapko sunna hai, aapne wohi suna. Baki ke time, you are just physically present, mentally somewhere else. Okay. The next is attentive listening. That is what is good listening, where you leave everything aside, you give that person your 100% attention, and you listen to them. And then the topmost of the ladder is empathetic listening. Now, what do I mean by empathetic listening? Anybody?
Listening is empathetic listening is something that we can say as a whole, getting the whole gist of the conversation by listening to it.
Yes, that is there, but not the the right answer, Subrat. Empathetic listening means wherein you try and put yourself into the shoes of the person who's speaking. That does not literally mean you have to ask them, please remove your shoes, I need to wear them. Okay. What it means is you try to put yourself into the situation of the person. Now, if somebody is sharing a very bad news with you, probably they have lost a job or they've lost a loved one or whatever it is. You have to be a listener, but with empathy. That is, you put yourself into their condition and shoes, and then you think from their point of view. That is known as empathetic listening. Okay. So these are all levels of listening, but the topmost where is you need to concentrate on is attentive and empathetic listening. Is that clear? I hope that's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Fantastic. Now, what we're going to move on to is the 7 C's of communication, which means your communication, whether it's verbal communication or it's communication through email, whether it's communication through your telephones or whatever is the medium of communication, your communication should have 7 C's. Now, what are these 7 C's? I want you all to write this down so that you all don't forget it. The first C is completeness, means all that information which is required should be there. Your communication should not be incomplete. So it has to have all the required information. Second is C is conciseness. It has to be to the point, not very wordy. Nobody has a time to listen to kahanis. Okay. Nobody has a time to listen to stories. They want you to be direct and to the point. So your communication should not beat around the bush. It should come directly to the point. The third is consideration, which means that are you focused on yourself or are you focused on the other person? Are you considerate about them? That is the third C. The fourth C is clarity, which means getting your message across to the receiver who understands what you're actually trying to convey. So your message should be, or your communication should be clear. There has to be clarity. Concreteness, which means that your communication should have facts and figures, which show that it is right. So that's concreteness. The next C is courtesy, which is on the same lines as consideration. So your communication should have manners. It should have courteousness. It should have, you should consider the feelings of the other person. That's courtesy. And the last C is correctness, which means that you should be, your communication should not have any incorrect things. It should be right clear in thought and expression and checking the accuracy of facts and figures and words. So grammatically correct, if there's any wrong data that has to be corrected. So that's correctness. Okay, so these are 7 C's of communication. Now I want to show you a small video with regards to this. Let me do that. Whenever you're communicating, try and use these 7 C's in your communication. Okay, very, very important. Clear? All right. Now, moving on from here, there are 3 types of communication style. Okay. The first one is passive communication. Now, what do we understand by passive communication? Anybody? Passive communicating style. Anybody knows what that is?
Some kind of an
submissive
kind of communication.
Sorry, it is
kind of an indirect.
No, not really. So I'll explain what is passive communication is where you are communicating in a very as a person who is not very confident. Okay, so a person who gets treated like a doormat, that kind of a person is what is a passive communicator, wherein you just do ha me ha of the other person. You don't have a own point of view. You don't have a something that you stand to. Just give me a second, everyone. That's all. I'm in a session. Can I call you back? Yeah, sure. Thanks. So what I was mentioning is that you have to make sure that you're passive as a communicator, as a passive person. You would be somebody who's very, not very direct with your way of speaking. Means you will go round the bush. You will be a little not very confident with your speech, with your body language, and you don't have a point of view. That's a passive communicator. Okay. Somebody who's an aggressive communicator is the opposite of passive, which means somebody who's aggressive is somebody who's very, you know how they are. The tone is very loud. The way they speak is very rude. So that's aggressiveness. Now, in between passive and aggressive, there is a there's a middle line, which is assertive. What is assertive communication style? Anybody? Assertive communication?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Assertive communication means somebody who is not very soft and feeble and somebody who's not very aggressive. That person is in the middle, which means they say what they have to say in a very polite manner, but at the same time, they don't, they're not rude. They are not very polite, but they get their points across because they're firm in their communication. Okay. Now I'm going to show you some videos for you to have an idea about what are these styles of communication. Let me just find that video one. Just give me a minute. Yeah, I got that now. All right. Have you seen the movie Sholay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so this is from there, okay? The 2 of the videos. Let me... So I'll show you the first video, which is... Should I scroll down?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Also, you have also got 40, right? Okay. So, Yeah. So what does a score mean? Let's quickly take a look at that. So if you are somebody who's 55 plus, you are assertive most of the time and you handle most of the situation well, you might benefit from a few new ideas to improve your skill and communication and effectiveness. If you are falling between 40 to 55, which I think both Mayuri, you and Subrata are falling, you are fairly assertive. You could probably use some practice to be more consistent in your assertive behavior. So it means that you're already falling into assertiveness style of communication, Subrata and Mayuri, but you just have to have more, be more consistent in it. So somewhere you are lacking the consistency. The more consistent you are, the more your assertiveness style will be more coherent. Okay. 25 to 14, there's nobody is falling under this. But yeah, if you were somebody like that, then your usual response is either non-assertiveness or aggressiveness. So that person comes more as an aggressive kind of a style of communication. So what is assertiveness? Wherein you're able to express your feelings and thoughts openly and honestly to others. And that is the space we want to be in. In communication, you should be able to openly share your thoughts in an honest manner, but not in a passive way or aggressive way, in a right manner with the right kind of tone and firmness in your voice. Okay, so how do we communicate purposely? These are a few of the things that we can do to communicate purposely. You have to have a purpose in your communication that has to be clear and concise. You should be able to understand other people's feelings and thoughts and have a calm demeanor. Even though you may be undergoing a lot of emotional inner conflict, you still have to put up a calm demeanor. You saw in the video of Gandhi, right? How even though the situation around him was so aggressive and so conflict and emotional, but he still was able to maintain his calm and composure. Yeah. So that's something that I wanted to share with you with regards to assertiveness style of communication. Do you have any questions with regards to today's session? Do you have anything that you want to ask? Any doubt, any clarification? Please go ahead and do that right now.
There are some situations which demand a different kind of communication style, such as wherein we have to be aggressive or very passive. So how to judge that, what to do?
Yes. So as I was mentioning, Subrat, a little while back, there is no right manner of communication or right style of communication. Yes, there will be times and situations wherein you have to have aggressiveness in your communication because you want somebody to do something and that person is still not doing it, right? But just aggressiveness can harm your image, can harm your personality as such. What you can do is understand, take a pause and understand, with this kind of a person or this kind of a situation, if I become aggressive or if I have to be passive, will I get the result that I want out of the situation? Okay. From that point of view, then you have to maneuver and manipulate and be a little tactful and switch on to your assertiveness style of communication. Now, I'll just give you a small example. Suppose you have a team member or suppose you have a friend whom you feel has to do something, you're doing a project together, for example, and that person is not contributing his ideas. You are working by yourself and it has to be a team effort, right? And you tell him once, you tell him twice, you tell him thrice, and that person is just not contributing towards that project. He is not, being a part of it at all. So then you have to, instead of being aggressive and losing your temper and your cool on that person, think of it in a calm manner, take a pause and put up a assertiveness style of communication wherein you tell them, boss, that this project has to be submitted by X date, for example, say by the 5th of July, and we still haven't gotten work started on it. And I feel I'm the only one who's doing it. And I'll really appreciate if you can contribute your ideas to this particular project because that will help us deliver the project to our teacher on time. So something from that point of view, you want to be aggressive, because but you can't be. You have to still maintain that assertiveness in your communication. Put your message, your communication openly and honestly to your friend, but at the same time, be assertive. Okay? I hope that answered.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah? So try and just think of, so the biggest leaders today are all assertiveness, are all assertive in their way of communication. And that's the kind of level we would want you all to be in. Okay. To be successful, you have to have assertiveness as a way of communication rather than the other two. Okay, Mayuri, any questions from your side? Any doubts, anything at all?
No, ma'am.
No, all clear? So quick recap, what did we do today? Umang, are you there with us? Yes, she is. Umang, please write down your key learnings from today's session in the chat box. What did you learn? And Suvrat and Mayuri, what are your takeaways from the session today? Please unmute and speak. What did you learn today?
In today's session, first of all, how to structure a speech properly and how to maintain the flow of the speech, like giving stress to different words which are important, taking pause where it is necessary. Then apart from it, the 7 C's of communication.
Right.
How to be a proper communicator and the styles of communication in which we have to address the other person. To make it more effective. And the tone, the importance of tone, that the fun activity that we did.
Yes.
How to read other person's emotions from their tone. That's all I got.
Fantastic. And Mayuri, you've already put it into the chat box, right? And Umang as well. Thank you so much for your contribution. Okay, so that brings us to the end of another great session. I hope you all enjoyed the session. I hope you all liked it and learned something in today's session.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Okay. So today's homework is very simple. When we started our day today, you wrote about, you remember the My Passion topic that you all had to speak about, right? So Suvrat, Mayuri and Umang, I would want you all to redo that My Passion wala script from the point of view of whatever you know, feedback I had given you on your areas of improvement. Rework that, and tomorrow's class you have to present once again with your areas of improvement, that whatever was highlighted. Okay, there has to be a good opening, closing, body of the structure of the presentation, body language, everything, whatever we've spoken about. I want you all to include all those ingredients in your speech tomorrow. Okay, so practice it properly. And tomorrow's class, we will start this with this My Passion thing. Okay, and then we'll move on to tomorrow's session. All clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so thank you very much for attending our session today. Umang, I would want you all to want you to be really regular, because you are getting logged off again and again. So please check your connectivity. You will lose out on some important points of our session. Okay, so please try and see whatever best you can do to be more regular and not getting logged out. Okay, so I'll see you all tomorrow. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye-bye.
Bye.